Their key witnesses were Inspector Anderson, who was the chief investigating officer, Mr. Elodia Gunn, who was then the officer in charge of the Eastern Division, Mr. Vidal, who was then a member of GSU, who claimed that he was the one the person said I would confess to. And those were their witnesses, and Mr. Romero, who was the person who took the statement, and of course in this case, the person who witnessed the statement was ill and they only submitted the written statement. For the defense, the accused took the stand under oath, and he explained how he was beaten, how he was not given to eat, and how he was threatened, that the life of his family members was threatened by Mr. Vidal. And then thereafter, he was forced to give a statement. What the judge looked at when he gave his summing up, he said that he looked at three things to him. That the accused was saying, look, I was even told my constitutional right so that I could get an attorney. The second thing he is saying that he looked at is that the accused said, look, I wasn't even given water to drink or food to eat for over 24 hours before they made me sign the statement. And three, that the accused is saying, I was threatened and I was beaten and I have the bruises to show it. The judge concluded that he believed that the accused was read his rights. But he said that on the second point, he believes that the prosecution failed to prove that this person was fed and watered. And when the question was placed to Mr. Vidal, Mr. Aragon, and Mr. Romero, they said blatantly they didn't even bother to ask him, well, have you eaten? Have you had something to drink? In his evidence, the accused said he didn't even get to sleep. That is how bad it was for him. So on that point, the prosecution failed to prove, and they have records at the, if you know how the police system works, when you go into the police station, they have a diary and they enter what time you came, who put you in a cell, who took you out, if you were fed, if you had a visitor. That's evidence the prosecution could have brought to the court to prove that, look, everything this man says is a lie, so we can prove it. But they never brought that evidence to court. On the third point, whether he was threatened or beaten, the judge says, you know, the young man came and said he was beaten. The prison brought their records. There's a photograph taken by one of the prison officials that shows bruises on his neck and on his wrist, in line with his evidence. The duty of the prosecution was to prove or to rebut that that didn't happen. None of them said that or brought any evidence to prove otherwise. On the contrary, they should have disproved it, and they couldn't. So on those two points, it was believed that the story of the accused is correct, and as such, he was found not guilty.